business, with designing hats, and the people that work for me. I'll trade hats, if I can get the secret baklava ingredient for the best baklava in the world. I have people waiting. It's your grandmother. She has it.
But what about every dino in the city carries baklava?
No.
Don't they sell it to you?
Don't tell me about baklava around the world. There's no other baklava better than Sylvia's. All of this for a secret ingredient. This is just a start. This is just tonight to make a contract.
Ramona also seduced others into her web, including Harold, then just a small-time baklava dealer.
You know what Mae West said? It's not the men in my life. It's the life in my men.
I got a lot of life.
Before we order the pizza, I think you better, try and get another package of cigarettes. You, the cigarette thief.
Yeah.
You know, let me tell you something. If you can take your van, and with my cash, I can pay you transporting from Princeton all of the baklava from Sylvia grandmother. I, for your $10 packages of cigarettes, can take care of you very well, baby.
Oh.
Cigarettes, baklava, back and forth. Princeton, Grandmama, Auntie Ramona, she's here for you.
Sounds great.
And so now, Harold too learned who Sylvia was.
That would be so generous. That would be ideal for a nice coffee and a piece of baklava. Give me your recipe and I'll do it.
Yeah, I can.
And you come to my place.
Oh.
How do you make that delicious baklava?
Now because my neck hurt me. Sorry.
Clandestine implications of baklava addiction. Is it really worth it?
I have to leave you now, but I'll see you later in about an hour. I'll be at your house. And get out the baklava, okay? All right, thank you. I'll have a lovely piece.
I have been her daughter a long time.
And I don't know how to tell the kids, Mom. They want to know how to do the baklava. And I don't know how to make the baklava. It's time to find the secret.
Ramona. Oh, yes. Yes, I have left the van full of baklava near JFK. Yeah. At the terminal you told me about. Yep, that's it. It's there. What about the money? All right. Hope you have a nice day.
Yes.
You'll never know it was my Aunt Zuma's baklava.
But you must tune into every episode.
She'll think it's Sylvia's.
A tour thought he had tricked Ramona and gotten away with it. But Ramona was not so easily deceived.
Sending me to LA tomorrow to be the new baklava ambassador. On to another day of trading baklava.
Early in the morning, he was on a plane to Los Angeles. Ramona secretly decided to join him last minute to poison him with moldy baklava while in midair. But before she had a chance to offer him the poisonous mold, suicide terrorists hijacked their plane and crashed it into the Twin Towers of Manhattan. Learning of the death of his muse, Rasputin was completely devastated.
Where are you going?
Today I'm flying to LA, remember?
No, you are wrong.
I told
you. We are going nowhere.
By chance, Wendy was supposed to have been on that same flight.
Got a great acting job in LA in a sitcom.
Yeah, you can find thousands of jobs in New Jersey and in New York and all around the area. You don't need to go so far.
But then I have to take this job.
Unless you're becoming the governor of LA, I will accept, not less than that.
It was there that she first met Harold. She didn't know that he had followed her there. They became karaoke buddies. By that point, Harold was already deeply involved in the baklava trade. Harold showed Wendy a way to start making real money.
But they were being watched. Harold told Wendy's family that he had a dying uncle who needed to eat many pounds of baklava daily to keep alive. So they all begged Sylvia to make it for him. But one day, Harold talked Wendy into helping him with an idea that he had, setting Aunt Zuma's warehouse on fire. Harold spoke fast of all the riches that awaited them. Wendy knew it wasn't something right to do, yet she went along. Zuma's was the world's leading distributor of baklava. Destroying his warehouse forever ends his empire, opening the door for Harold's version of Sylvia's baklava to hit the market.
Baklava, ambassador. If I want to do it, I have to decide by tonight to go back to LA. Promised me a lot of dough. As you know, babe, money talks, bullshit walks. Ooh, perfect shot. How's that? Right? Ooh.
Wendy could not go along.
So, why you have to go to LA? You're going to leave your family? Is your family important to you or not? Tell me, I want to hear that. Tell me.
Harold was quick to leave for LA, leaving Wendy behind.
Sorry about our relationship, baby, but, you know, money talks. Everything else walks.
As she drove back home alone, Wendy started doing some soul searching and began realizing something was wrong. Suddenly, a bright light was shining. The police got Harold right as he walked into the terminal. Wendy was lucky. They didn't take her. Wendy had to start making some changes,
but didn't know where to start. The ghost of Arthur had been haunting that part of town, where he had been killed. Arthur told Wendy of his tragic tale.
Nothing compared to the trauma of seeing the towers go down one by one, you know, it was just pretty, everybody was oohing and aahing, and at that time, I decided that, you know, I had to go back to the city, and that's what I did.
And Wendy told him about Harold, baklava, and singing. Arthur said, the key to singing is the same as the key to world peace.
That's what I did.
And then he mysteriously vanished.
Listen. Here is a sign you may or may not understand. All things in the heavens and the earth are in harmony, coming together to form a single whole greater than the sum of its parts. So too is the purpose of your languages and races, your nations and tribes. Vanity, wasteful futilities that exalt nothing, propel the machinery of offensive war, behind which cowardice laughs at your self-aggrandizing, jingoistic stupidity. Find and master your violence. Step outside yourself. Step outside of history. See reality for what it is, not what you think it is. Failure to do this is suicide, a suicide abhorred by God and by nature. World peace? It's no longer an idealistic dream. It's a survival tactic.
Is there something like a tolerance, religious tolerance, that would actually help us to achieve that peace, or do you think that religions all together, the conflict between the separate religions is unavoidable?
I don't know why religions fight. I really don't know why they fight, because there's one God, according to me, but why are they fighting? What are they fighting about? I mean, they are religious, and they should want the whole world to be at peace. I don't understand them.
These were the people that sat next to you on the train into New York City from the suburbs in New Jersey and Connecticut, Long Island, Brooklyn, early in the morning in the cold frost. These were the people that were your neighbors, the people you saw every day going to their jobs, people that you passed by on the street or on the stores. Those were the same people that were killed in the gas chambers of the Holocaust.
The baklava maker, Sylvia, had been through the Holocaust.
To take us to Athens. Mm-hmm. By the time who you need, she disappeared. We don't know what to do. It was very... After I left Salonika, I was in Athens.
How did you went to Athens?
I go from Salonika to Athens, because it was the Italian there. The Italian don't touch them.
Oh, so you were safe there? You were safe?
It was safe for a little bit, because after the Germany came and said, Athens.
That's right, they did.
And we left from there.
And then where from there? Where did you go?
2 years, 2 years. I was underground. It was very bad.
When you were hiding?
Yes.
You were living with many different families?
Yes, sure. And one don't know where the other. Mm-hmm. Because if you know, Germany they take you and they do very, very bad things. And after you say the truth, they are very, very ugly. Nobody knows the one from the other.
Sylvia thought people did mean things out of jealousy, a lack of understanding. New York City suddenly had ruins, like World War II ruins in Europe. Ghost buildings and ghost people. It's time to start finding solutions, solutions that really work. Out there in the crowd, solutions must exist.
I think we should look for them.
Yeah.
We wouldn't have the right, you know, to go destroy a country.
At that time, people came out of their shell.
Yeah.
They put their indifference on the side and they concentrated on the major thing. I mean, you didn't hear the horns in New York for a week or two or three.
When you hate someone else, it's almost like hating yourself. And that's really the only solution. Love is the only antidote to hatred.
Basically, in California, in Los Angeles, people from film should not speak about politics. What is your comment about that?
Oh, listen, people in politics, they always speak about it. I mean, in the early days, and actors went to Washington to protest. And I mean, we like it. We know what we don't want to happen. And I really don't want there to be a war. I don't want there to be havoc in the world.
I don't have the microphone, so I don't know if I'm going to try to talk into this.
Okay.
So maybe we should sit down. Can you sit down for a second?
Sure, I can.
Okay.
That'd be nice, dude.
So I'm just going to ask you some questions about 9/11.
Okay. It's pretty much, you know, how I view it.
Okay, can you say it again? I don't think it was recording.
It wasn't recording. Oh.
Sorry.
Well, just, you know, the whole idea that, you know, when horrible things like this happen, you have to respond. You can't allow it to go without any, you know, retribution or punishment. However, you know, the government tends to, you know, overreact a lot of times and take away some of the freedoms that we're trying to protect, that they were trying to take away with the attack.
I just said to myself that I wish humanity would use the intelligence that they have, preserve life, and stop trying to end it.
If you find inner peace, you know, it's much easier to not lash out on others when, because everyone is crossed by others. So, you know, toes are always stepped on.
And a lot of times people are unaware of why they're fighting. A lot of times people are fighting because this condition that they have is all that they know.
Let me ask you, as far as from your perspective, because this documentary is like solution oriented, if you had a magic wand and you could change like people and stuff like that, how would you change the world and make it into a more positive place?
People couldn't believe that Wendy was actually giving Sylvia's baklava away. She used to be one of the biggest dealers in town not long ago.
My grandmother used to bake too.
Yeah.
She used to bake all sorts of things. Because yes, you need to grieve, and yes, you need to protect yourself, and yes, you never need to forget. On the other hand, when do you stop? And when do you start taking people as individuals?
It certainly made people more willing to be interviewed.
Baklava unites people. Was baklava the secret to world peace?
I mean, there's a famous story when the band started cooking, you know, the James Brown. GIs got up and started dancing. Apparently somebody looked out, you know, from way up on one of the lookout towers, and they saw a bunch of, you know, Viet Cong putting down their weapons, coming out of the bush. They started dancing too. So, I mean, everybody was kind of grooving to James Brown, you know, the Viet Cong and the Americans too. It had the effect of being able to bridge the gap of uniting everybody in a kind of a unified dance, celebration of life, as opposed to trying to, you know, destroy each other.
If anyone's been in a war and they see these people with missing arms and legs and heads, they would not just happily say, oh, let's go and have a war. It's the people who haven't been in it who it doesn't mean anything. Yes, oh, there'll be some people killed, yeah, well, it's too bad. But they don't know the reality of it.
War is just a slaughtering house and the salt's nothing.
I would have them get together into groups. The high school kids would come together from all the different warring factors and just live together, right? And go through training, sensitivity, that kind of thing.
You guys should live a more natural life.
I pretty much feel that all the people in the world are pretty much the same. We're so much alike, it's ridiculous.
As an artist and as a human being of these times, I think it's very important that we find ways to communicate with each other.
The most important one to me is feedback, because people use it to tell us what's going on right and what's going on wrong. That's our whole history. We listen to feedback, we find out what people need, we do it.
Is my beard on straight?
I think you might have to come closer because the sound won't record. Okay.
Exposure, communication, presenting things in ways that is accessible to different psychologies. One way of speaking to somebody might not work with another. The very real potential for world peace.
One day, out of the blue, Wendy got a phone call. It was Buddy, Ramona's friend. He was in New York on business and called to say hi.
I remember the first time I was in New York and I walked down Schubert Alley. Broadway was a prairie. It was that long ago.
He took over the project.
One man said to the other, "I'm trying to hear you, but my pride is speaking too loudly and it's drowning out all other sounds." His friend said, "Speak up. I can't hear you. The pollution in my heart is making a terrible racket. And I'm not really listening. I'm only waiting for you to stop talking so I could say something." Was that narrative familiar? Did you feel a bit of pain, of embarrassment, from recognizing yourself in that pitiful exchange? Don't be embarrassed. It's just a part of life. But before you weep with shame or tell me to go to hell, consider this. Is not the acknowledgement of the non-self the hardest thing for the ego to do? Breaking down the barriers and seeing through others' eyes. Listening to yourselves, listening to others, and removing that which separates us. This is the first step in the science of love.
Wendy went back to singing and listened to the music more.
So we gotta find out what key you're gonna do, Stardust then.
Listening very carefully, Wendy now practiced singing 3 hours a day. Buddy wanted to re-edit the documentary a little, and then he organized a few screenings.
And if you were president of the world?
That would be the day.
Project promoting friendship and understanding over jealousy and hate. Artist produced and solution oriented. Sylvia's Baklava is the featured documentary, AKA When There Is a Will, There Is a Way. It is a very insightful, potentially groundbreaking piece. Lots of underground ideas are exposed and the audience will become enlightened about relatively simple ways that can make a huge difference in the way our world works. Things do not have to be the way they are. We don't have to be bombing each other. We don't have to have people committing suicide, etc., etc. This documentary turns around the values that are our mainstream society and showcases alternatives, solutions. If these solutions become embraced in the mainstream, we could be living in a beautiful world because there would be understanding and friendship for all.
Congratulations for your documentary. But next time, you have to have a better camera. Right? Wendy, next time, better one. You have to buy another.
Near the Ground Zero site, there was a piano bar with an open mic night for singers.
Good evening, everyone. As Jean-Luc Godard once said, are we in a movie or are we in real life? Right now, we are in real life, and we have our open mic night at the Camel of the Nile Bar. And right now, I'd like to present our wonderful bassist, Mr. Barb Arkin. My name is John Weiss. And we'd like to ring up our first performer for this evening, the lovely Wendy. Come on, Wendy, and meet your audience.
Hi.
Hi, Wendy, how are you?
Good, how are you?
Ready to go to work?
Yes. I saw the key of C, which probably don't even need the music.
She's going to do Stardust in the key of C. No, we don't need the music. Here it is. Don't stand in front of the speaker. Why don't you stand in front of the piano?
Okay.
You want to do Stardust?
Chance, coincidence, or fate, an old acquaintance of Wendy's came in for a drink that night after work. The famous theater producer, Alex A. Capella.
Don't call us, okay? We call you.
So now he did call.
You're probably wondering why I called you after our first meeting wasn't that pleasant. I'm preparing a Broadway show, and I was thinking to have a small part for you in it.
Wendy got a real acting job. The colorful days of autumn quickly withered away, and soon winter arrived. On a frosty, crisp morning during the first week of the new year, Sylvia's doorbell rang. Baklava thief was none other than Sylvia's closest friend, Estelle.
It's a honey cake.
Thank you.
Smell it.
Estelle now brings a honey cake. As usual, she wants a piece or two of baklava.
It's the best.
Yeah. And will you give me a baklava recipe? Your baklava is the best.
I have to write. I cannot remember.
Oh, you've been making it for so many years.
Yes, I make so many years, but I cannot remember.
Sylvia divulges her secret.
How do you start?
We start with the filo.
Yes.
You have to put filo.
How many?
Butter. 10 in the butter.
Yes.
And after you put nuts.
Yes.
Sugar.
Yeah.
And cinnamon. You mix all together.
Yes.
But you have to the nuts to put in the blender.
Yes, to break them out. Yes, to chop.
2 cups of sugar,
yeah.
1 cup of water,
yeah.
To boil.
Yeah, yeah.
There. When it's boiling, after it is boiling,
yeah.
But you saw the boil is coming from outside, inside.
Yes.
The first, and after they have to come from inside, outside.
Yes.
And cinnamon.
You said cinnamon's in it?
Yeah, sure.
I didn't realize. I didn't have any cinnamon.
Cinnamon! How could I have missed that?
Yes.
Oh, I didn't
didn't I think of that? That was the secret ingredient.
Yes.
Cinnamon. Oh, thank goodness. Thank you so
very
much.
You're welcome.
The only one?
Yes.
Oh, what a privilege. Yes, yes. Thank you so much.
You're very, very welcome.
Hello? Come on out. Come on, Cappuccino. Go over there. Someone is hiding there. Go, quick.
The latest show to hit the air is Rasputin's musical journey.
The only good baklava is Sylvia's baklava. The ancient Greek recipe handed down from generation to generation in the ancient caves of ancient Greece. Baklava.
Katina now sells baklava on eBay, and Wendy drives into the city to rehearse her Broadway show. Parking is always a big problem in the Big Apple. Next time, take a bus, Wendy. Sylvia considers the menu. So many options.
So, what will it be today?
Green cheese again.
Green cheese and french fries again? You're Sylvia who makes the baklava,
yes,
right?
Yes.
Your baklava is wonderful. People are talking about it. And I was thinking, I'd like to sell it here. So how about if, like, you give me the recipe, and I'll let you eat here free every day for a month. So I know you're coming here, you like our grilled cheese. Is that okay?
No.
Why not?
We're talking about time.
Well, tell me what you want. How about 2 months? 2 months eating free, grilled cheese, french fries?
A percentage?
You want a percentage, I see. All right, well, what percentage do you want? Think about what we talked about yesterday?
Yes.
What do you think?
Percentage.
That makes it very easy.
But then how she controls what you sell.
What do you mean? I make it according to her recipe.
Yes, but then if she wants percentage, how it's going to work out?
You're right.
Because it's her name.
Because the next thing you know, people saying, hey, Sylvia's baklava is no good anymore.
Yes, yes.
So we'll make a contract that's renewable every month. And she has to approve of it. You know, she'll taste it every month, okay?
At first, Sylvia was a little sad to have given away her recipe. But she quickly got over it, as she realized she was doing a good thing. By making her recipe legal and available at last, it would stop the dangerous addictions, end the crimes associated with the baklava trade, and thus also end the days of the underground baklava mafia. Soon, everywhere you turn, you could see Sylvia's baklava for sale. Paparazzi started following Sylvia everywhere. Katina negotiated unlimited TikTok food for a year, besides a great percentage. People lined the streets to buy Sylvia's baklava at the TikTok diner. They sold thousands of pieces in a few hours that first weekend.
Sylvia, we're dedicating our menu to you.
Look, isn't that nice? After you finish with the baklava, you'll start selling diamonds.
Sylvia's family wanted to sell baklava all over the country and overseas too. This was big business around the world. Sylvia agreed to make it, but she wanted 80% of the profits. And that was not negotiable. They agreed.
Change all around the country. The logistics of becoming a chain of Sylvia's baklava.
I think it's better on a franchise basis.
Prepared and ready to go tomorrow.
Maybe we can.
By midnight.
Yes, maybe yes, maybe no.
Kilos.
I don't know. It's pound of baklava. I don't know.
And I have to cut. If you make the baklava, I cut the baklava. Then I can go back.
I am ready for tomorrow. I can't do tomorrow. We'd be rich.
Can you do it?
No.
Tomorrow?
I am not sure. I don't know. I don't promise. I don't promise. Maybe yes.
I try. I can't believe they want me to drop everything that I'm doing and go help make the baklava. I have a really important audition tomorrow. It's a callback
for a really important show. I have to learn 10 lines of dialogue between now and tomorrow morning, and they want me to drop everything that I'm doing and go inside and make baklava. I can't believe it. I coordinated this whole deal. I did everything else. Why can't they make the baklava? I can't believe this. I can't believe this. They should be making the baklava, not me. I don't even know how to make it.
Okay, let's go.
Let's go and start making the baklava.
Let's go.
Let's go.
Sylvia certainly appreciated the eager volunteer helpers. Baklava also brewed into the perfect hot beverage, naturally sweet and caffeine-free.
Baklava with almond, baklava with ice cream, everything is baklava, baklava
is the best. Shock. They've been sweeping the country. It's been a baklava explosion.
Yes, yes. We are going to bring the best flour from Canada and the best butter from France. Everything is baklava. Everything smells baklava. And everything becomes baklava.
As long as I make the percentage and he does the work, no problem for me.
The Sylvia's Baklava fashion line was introduced later on that year.